Supported by growing internet penetration and quickly adopting citizens, e-commerce has gradually gained ground in Uganda. Ronnie Kaumara, Chief Executive Officer, Jumia Uganda, one of the pioneer companies of e-commerce in the country, says the growth has been majorly private sector driven. It's against this background that he urges the government not to take harmful policies to the industry.
The future of e-commerce and the future online business is great, because we know that business goes where people are. You know, the history of cities, right? And the history of economies and business thrives where there's masses, right? That's why there's much more economic activity in Kampala than in my village, right? Because there's more people here. And so we know very well that more and more people are going online, that there's more people congregating on Facebook and on YouTube and on Google than in a stadium somewhere. So the biggest communities of Ugandans can be found online. So we know very well that because of that, e-commerce will thrive and will grow.
Kaumara said some of the government actions over the last 10 years, like introduction of over-the-top tax and a 12% levy on the internet, have been detrimental to their business that has built over time.
Now, we are definitely the first movers. We're the first movers. We're the first company to really do this at scale in Uganda. And we've seen that customers have responded. And they're buying in numbers. They're coming back. They're buying things small and large, from basic essentials of groceries to biggest appliances, the most expensive phones to the cheapest shoes. People are buying it and buying it more frequently. We've seen that the adoption rate or the number of people coming in is increasing. And so those are good signs, and that bodes well for the future of e-commerce. More people are buying as selling online. So the future is here.
Jumia says 60% of its vendors are women, while 95% businesses using the platform are small and medium enterprises. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.